Hello, everybody, and welcome to Let's Not Play Modern Warfare 2. Seriously, let's not play any more of that game because we've played so bloody much of it already. What? I'm your host, T, and this is my co-host, Jesse.
What's up? Right. Actually, on. You know what? I think I'm going to go play some tonight.
You can do that. I don't need to
I need to unlock those level 38 pistols.
Well, you've already unlocked those level 38 pistols.
Once.
So the reason I'm doing this one here, Jesse's just along for the ride, is because me and Jesse picked up Modern Warfare 2 around the same time. I got it a little earlier. Well, we had it around the same time.
Yeah.
And we played through all of the multiplayer segments of it together. Everything from Spec Ops to online. I am now 137% done online, and Jesse is probably 150-something.
I'm about 140-something.
Oh, boy. All right. So it just goes to show you we've been playing this game for a while. Now, Modern Warfare 2. Fine game of all rights. I didn't play the first Modern Warfare. Bring it on, nerds. Find me if you can. No.
The first one's really good.
I'm sure it is. I'm just not paying $40 for it. We played. It's a fine game as is, but I think I read my statistics, and I'm up to something like 5 days of Modern Warfare 2. And I don't want to play 5 days of any video game. So why are we still playing, Jesse?
Because it's just fun to pick up and just take your gun, take your mini Uzi and just go.
You leave Susie out of this. So, alright, let's start there. Favorite gun, go.
Favorite gun? I don't have a favorite gun, dude.
He's useless.
I just use a whole bunch of guns. Don't move your microphone away from me.
I did it for a reason. Alright, no. Okay, let's start with somewhere we actually can start. So, you like the story mode of Modern Warfare?
Number one, I like the story. Number two is okay, but it was a little stupid.
You want to really give them a spoiler-free story of Modern Warfare 2?
World War 3.
You want to give a better story of Modern Warfare 2?
Well, I can't really not spoil much.
Just talk about this game.
Okay, well, it starts off. What do you do in the beginning again?
Do we have a name? Does our character have a name?
He's called Roach. At least, actually, we got like three different characters through the course of this game.
Okay, start there.
I don't remember their names.
Okay, just tell us about the characters.
Okay, the first guy you use is just, they keep take him into the CIA and make him go into Russia, which you do a terrorist attack an airport, get killed, and that's the end of that. And then you go to use Roach, which you follow Soap, which is your character in the first game, and you destroy an enemy base, and then you just leave. And then it ends up being you're just a Marine in the military, I think, for the rest of the game. For most,
I meant, give us like some. What do you know about the characters? Not what they
do. Nothing much. All I know is that the Infinity Ward has a fetish for Captain Price. He's in every Call of Duty they make.
Okay, there, buddy. Slow your roll. That could be a spoiler for anyone who hasn't played the game. Anyway, so what do we know of the story? It's essentially the Russians are doing what?
They're attacking America because. One American with a bunch of other Russians went to an airport in Russia and shot a bunch of people. So completely impossible because, in real life, if like one American went and murdered a bunch of Russians, let's take it this way. If a Russian came to America and murdered a bunch of people, you really think America is going to declare war on Russia?
Oh,
it's
goodness.
Not happening. And Russia wouldn't do it either. It'd be like, what the hell, America, right? So, you know, why are you letting these people get here? But they wouldn't be like, let's kill all Americans, you know?
Yeah, I'm sure they wouldn't freak out the way they did. I believe they're also chasing a terrorist, aren't they?
Yeah.
Specifically named Makarov.
Makarov. Yeah, he's the one who did it. He's Russian, by the way.
Okay, whatever.
He's the one.
May be.
You know, he's their own guy, you know.
Okay.
Just saying.
So, we have a story. As the story mode, how long did you spend on the story mode? I don't mean on, like, in total. I'm just talking about your first playthrough.
Probably about 4 hours.
4 hours. Kind of a lot of money to invest in a 4-hour game, huh?
I don't know, man. You probably paid $50 for Contra, which is like a half an hour game.
Well, let's not get into Contra. Alright. So, let's talk about the next thing, the next major thing. First of all, I'm going to ask you this in story mode. What's the lure to story mode? What's the lure? Why would I want to play story mode?
If you enjoy story. If you played the first one, then yes, you definitely would want to play the second one, which is the reason why I wanted to. That's about it for me.
Right on. Alright, so
I don't know. Why did you play the story mode?
Because I didn't buy it for story. I just have an obsessive compulsive disorder the size of the Eiffel Tower. And if I buy a game, I tend to finish it. So me and Jesse, moving on, Spec Ops, let's talk about that. We did every Spec Ops mission. We are currently trying to beat it on veteran mode. We have two more levels to do, high explosive and the prisoner escape
wet
one.
Wet work is called, I think.
Wet work.
We can do that one if we just gotta get to the hostages, but the
yeah, we
one
can
way
to
like with the way to shoot with the juggernauts with explosives is impossible.
Yeah.
We got the one with sniper rifles, that one is easy as shit. You know? But sniper rifles are like, you know, just sit there and shoot them while they're running at you, but with the explosives and you're in town, and they always spawn around the corner, pff, you're dead.
Okay, so aside from our career gripes with the game, Jesse, Spec Ops is pretty much the co-op mode for Spec Ops is pretty much the co-op mode that story mode didn't get. You can't play co-op within story, which is stupid, might I point out. I don't see why this is a big issue, but I could see it coming into play with like one or two missions, but nothing that they should have just like totally edited out, right? I mean, like when you're in a cutscene, for instance, just make it one character. Anyway, so Spec Ops is like their answer to co-op. It's kind of like they take scenes from the first Modern Warfare and this Modern Warfare, and they let you live out scenarios, but you have a friend, or they're made up, like they've just made them special. So there is a section in Spec Ops where you have to ride snowmobiles and race the against the clock to make it to the end of the stage, which is a scene early off in Modern Warfare 2. Something you get to do, but you do a co-op. I don't know why that needs to be co-op, but
why not?
It's cool. It's fun. That's what matters, right? You want to race your buddy in Skidoos? Go for it. So, something we noticed is Spec Ops, you see things like new guns, new enemies, and new missions. One of our favorite new enemies being the Juggernaut.
My favorite enemy.
Yo, he's your favorite enemy.
No,
makes him your favorite enemy. The Juggernaut is a reality ripping super soldier that they seem to like to drop on you periodically. His ability to dimensionally warp beside you, no matter wherever you end up matter to be. So, I'm turning the corner. I'm automatically dead. Why? Because he willed it to be so. The Juggernaut is the Chuck Norris of Modern Warfare 2. Again, we are currently trying to finish it. We're doing an okay job.
You got to 5 left out of 10.
We only have 2 more stars to get, and then we get our star. I believe it's star 69, right?
Yeah.
Trophy. We played on PS3. Yeah, that's right. PS3.
Wow.
All right. Let's talk about what everyone actually came here to listen to. Multiplayer mode. Favorite game type.
Probably just team deathmatch or search and destroy. Maybe.
You sicken me. All right. You're going to tell me you play search and destroy over a game like Counter-Strike.
Yeah, I've never played Counter-Strike. I have, but I didn't like it. But
okay, I better do this now. For those who didn't play Counter-Strike or Search and Destroy, they're the same concept. One team has to complete an objective. It's either plant a bomb or... Well, it's always plant a bomb in Modern Warfare 2. But in Counter-Strike, it can be capture the bomb or plant the bomb or save the hostages. The catch is, if you die in this game, you don't respawn. You have to wait till the round's over. So it's essentially your elimination match with fatal consequences. You got to either kill the other team or complete the objective. This game gets pretty hectic. It's pretty competitive. And yes, we played we played so much Search and Destroy. At least 40 of our levels we can accumulate to just us sitting there playing Search and Destroy every night. So go ahead.
What about it?
Your favorite game type? Why?
Team deathmatch, because you just jump in and just shoot a bunch of people. I like Search and Destroy because you get lots of experience, and like if you kill someone, they're gone, right?
It's like nice to know they're dead.
Yeah, and like you get like lots of experience, and you get like huge satisfaction from killing someone in that game mode.
Prey doesn't. Yes, it's again, if you know there's only two people on the team, and you're working really really hard to kill them. It's pretty nice to know when you kill him, he's not left to come up behind you and kill you.
Is it recording?
Okay, it's recording. Okay, ignore that, everybody. Yes, yeah, so my favorite game type is domination. Or not domination, I hate domination. Demolition, in which demolition is essentially the search and destroy mode, but you can respawn. and you have a time limit.
You get some people get like 93 kills.
That's why I like it. You can sit there if you're really good with your, you know, your stuff. You can go up and you can just destroy that game. That was really what made Modern Warfare 2 separate, right? Like killstreaks. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
The bonus to killing people in Modern Warfare 2 was, of course, killstreak rewards. So if I got 3 kills on you, we can see your team, provided they're not prepared
for
that.
You can't die, though.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. You can see their team.
You know what I'm talking about is you gotta get 3 kills in a row without dying.
Oh, of course. Yeah, it's not just 3 kills. It's a kill streak, so you need to get a streak of 3 kills.
Yeah, I'm just saying.
Anyway, if you were to get 4, you might get yourself a care package, right?
Yeah.
You get a care package that could be anything from a Harrier comes in to blow up the stage and give you some air support to a missile falls from the sky and kills whoever you wish to kill. If, of course, they're not inside or hiding, you know, have a riot shield faced up in the air and protecting themselves.
Work, from
it could have. It had potential. You know you were praying for him, too. So,
hey, you know I wasn't.
Kill him! So, yeah, that went reasonably well. Oh, all right, we need to get this out of the way. How much do you like the maps of Modern Warfare 2?
A lot of them, but a lot of them, like, only about 3 of them.
Be honest.
Quarry, Wasteland, and Karachi, or whatever it's called. I don't like those 3 maps.
And because...
Oh, yeah, and Rundown.
And Rundown. I like Rundown.
I don't know why I don't like them. I just don't like them.
Okay, so these maps, they're really detailed, right? You can probably... Like, that's why they're good, right?
Yeah.
Like, you can go in buildings. It's not just, like, a shell of a level. It's really detailed. The problem is there's only about 13, which is good number, but to get to level, like, 70, that's not quite enough. But this is where it comes in. This is where my problem stems. Map packs.
$15
See,
each.
Infinity Ward and Activision released 2 map packs recently, which I believe have 5 maps each. And I saw these map packs, and I was like, ooh, that one looks cool. That one looks sweet. Who doesn't want to have a game of Modern Warfare 2 in a carnival, right? When these map packs hit, every gamer who owned the game got the shock to find out that they actually were charging them $15.
Yeah, 2 of them were from the Modern Warfare 1.
Yes, they were charging them $15 for a map pack.
That's 2 of them, so that's $30.
If you want a new map, if you want 10 new maps, you have to pay $30, which is the price of a brand new game.
For at least DS. Yeah.
But the problem with that is who do they think they're kidding? Reshelling 2 maps.
Well, apparently like almost 20 million people or something like that bought it.
That's because 20 million people are Modern Warfare addicts. That's why we're having this video.
I'm Modern Warfare 2 addict, kind of, right? Like, I play it like at least once a week. But
religiously.
Neither of us bought them, just so you know.
Neither. I refuse to pay $15.
Yeah,
that means if I want to go out and buy this game and I only buy $20 PSN cards, I have to spend 75% of my PSN card on a Modern Warfare 2 map, which leaves me enough for like maybe a crappy theme, or, and I say crappy because the good ones cost about $6, right?
Yeah.
That leaves me about enough money for a theme or maybe a really old game. Not even enough for a PlayStation 1 game. How sick is that?
Yeah, because those are $5.99, so $6.
It's a really like lame thing to do.
Oh, you forgot tax.
What? Tax as well.
I don't know how they can tax downloads.
And
whatever.
Yeah, it's the other thing. You're not even paying $15 for these map packs. You're also paying more because you have to pay a tax. So they're charging
you tax also on the card you bought itself, and then tax on the download you bought with card.
I'm gonna try to wrap this
up.
That's
like tax twice. I'm just saying.
I would love to wrap this up in the first video so we can just post
it. Yeah, we're pretty much done.
We have not a lot to point out. We've got the juggernauts. We've got the online. The point is, let's stop playing Modern Warfare 2.
I don't know, man. I kind of want to play some tonight.
Oh, oh. I think we need. I think I won't play, but I think we need. I think we need a new multiplayer game. I'm leaning
Halo
to
Halo Reach.
Oh,
definitely.
No
I'm
more
so
Halo.
Oh, that looks so awesome. So excited.
We could also do one of those, I suppose. I can talk about Halo. I know about Halo. Regardless, so I think we need to let's not play Modern Warfare 2.
Okay, well, we got another multiplayer game. We got Continuum Shift.
Oh, goodness. I would like to formally announce that at some point or another, I plan on putting up a video of me and Jesse playing a series of split-screen multiplayer games with quite a bit of commentary in the middle. Look forward to that. And yes, one of them will be Modern Warfare 2. I'm going to drop him with my Uzis. That's how we roll.
Wait, but you don't use a Kimbo Uzi. Anyways, I think we're probably much done.
Yeah, I don't think we have much time. So I'm your host, T, and this is my co-host, Jesse.
What's up, homie?
And goodness, I hate you.
Why? Just go.
And this is this has been Let's Not Play Modern Warfare 2. Join us next time for Let's Not Play. What do you not want to play?
Modern Warfare 2. Actually, I do want to play, but Modern Warfare 2.
I don't know. We'll figure it out. Join us back next time. Bye-bye.